Good morning, everyone. So our today's lecture is on diaper rash. So basically, what do we mean by diaper rash? Diaper rash means it is the inflammation of the skin, which is found around the diaper area, especially in the infants and the young children. So by the term diaper rash, it means that it's a inflammation. It's a redness of the skin around the diaper area, especially in infants and young children. In this image, we can see it is diaper rash, the redness, the inflammation in the diaper area. Candidial diaper dermatitis, it's a ubiquitous problem in infants, and although relatively benign, is often frustrating because of its tendency to reoccur. Now, candidal diaper dermatitis, diaper rash, it is also called candidal diaper dermatitis. So, candidal diaper dermatitis, it's a ubiquitous problem. It's a widespread problem. Ubiquitous means it's a widespread problem in infants, and it is obviously benign. It is irritating. It is frustrating because its tendency to reoccur. Then the predisposed infants usually carry candidal albicans in their intestinal tract and the warm, moist, occluded skin of the diaper area that provides an optimal environment for its growth, for the growth of candida albicans. So basically, candidal diaper dermatitis, hum diaper rash ko candidal diaper dermatitis bhi bolte hain, and it's a widespread problem in the young infants and the children, young children up to 2 years of the age. And this problem, this diaper rash, this diaper dermatitis, it is a benign problem, but it is very frustrating for the child because it frequently reoccurs. And infants who are predisposed, what they do, they usually carry candida albicans in the intestinal tract, and that warms moist skin of the diaper area that provides a appropriate environment for the growth of candida albicans. This is irritant dermatitis also in infants due to prolonged contact with the feces and ammonia produced by the action of urea splitting organism in the urine. The area in contact with the diaper, that is the convexity of the buttocks, it shows a moist, glazed erythematous lesions with sparing of the depth of the flexures. So basically, diaper rash, what do we mean? That it's an inflammation, it's a redness of the skin in the diaper area in infants and young children up to 2 years. This is also called irritant dermatitis due to its prolonged contact with the feces and the ammonia. So the area which is in contact, that is the convexity of the buttocks, that shows that particular area of the skin, it shows a moist erythematous glazed lesions with sparing of the depth of the flexures. This is the exact image of diaper dermatitis or diaper rashes. And diaper rashes, they are more common in infants and young children, children up to 2 years or less than 2 years. But it is more prominent in the neonates up to 1 month of the age. And diaper rash, it is more common in artificially fed babies, bottle feed babies. Now, the etiological factors of diaper rash. So first is infections. Infections include ammoniacal dermatitis due to urine soiled diaper. Then infection by candida albicans. Obviously, we had discussed in the first slide that the predisposed infants, they carry candida albicans in the intestinal tract. So infection by candida albicans, ammoniacal dermatitis due to urine soiled diaper. And third is seborrheic dermatitis. Now again, seborrheic dermatitis, it's a skin disease. In this, there are rashes with itchy. The rashes are very itchy. So there are rashes on the skin with flakes. Flakes are there. So the skin is red and severe itching is present. इसको हम बोलते हैं क्रैडल कैप एंड इट यूजुअली अपीयर्स ऑन द स्कैल्प. सो इन्फेक्शंस इंक्लूड अमोनियाकल डर्मेटाइटिस ड्यू टू यूरिन सॉइल्ड डाइपर, इन्फेक्शन बाय कैंडिडा एल्बिकेंस एंड सिबोरिक डर्मेटाइटिस. नेक्स्ट इज इरिटेशन, कॉन्स्टेंट रबिंग ऑफ द स्किन, देन tight fitting diapers or any tight fitting clothing, then contact with any irritant chemicals. Now contact with irritant chemicals, they include any kind of harsh detergents or harsh soaps. So irritation caused by constant rubbing of the skin or the diapers when they are very tight fitted or tight clothing or harsh detergents or soaps. And the third category is any other pre-existing skin condition like eczema and atopic dermatitis. Now again, atopic dermatitis, it's a kind of the eczema. It's a common type of the eczema. It's a skin disease in which there are red blotches on the skin present. They are specially present on the face, arms and the legs, and severe itching is present. Then clinical manifestations. So till now we had discussed about what is diaper rash and etiological factors of diaper rash, that included infections, irritation and any other pre-existing skin condition. Now clinical manifestations. The primary clinical manifestation consists of an intensely, the primary manifestation would be intensely erythematous confluent plaques with a scalloped border. Now scalloped border means the border having semicircles, the edge or the border which is marked with the semicircles are there. It's a peculiar type of the border. So intensely erythematous confluent plaques with a scalloped border and sharply demarcated edge. It is formed by the confluence of numerous papules and vesicular pustules. Then satellite pustules, again important point. Satellite pustules, those that stud the contiguous skin, are the hallmark of localized candidal infection. Satellite pustules, they are the hallmark sign of the candidal infection. The perianal skin, inguinal fold, perineum and lower abdomen are usually involved. Yes. This is very important. The area which is involved in diaper rash are the buttocks, scrotal sac, mons pubis, inner thigh, lower abdomen. Now, this is a picture. Erythematous confluent plaques caused by candidal infection. What we had discussed in the last slide, this. The primary manifestation of diaper rash, it consists of intensely erythematous confluent plaques with a scalloped border and a sharply demarcated edge. Now this erythematous confluent plaques, this we will discuss in this slide. This is the erythematous confluent plaques, the primary manifestation of candidal diaper dermatitis. This is the exact image of erythematous confluent plaques. Then what we had seen, which is formed by the confluence of numerous papules and vesicular pustules. So this is the erythematous confluent plaques, the primary manifestation of candidal infection. In males, the entire scrotum and penis may be involved with an erosive balanitis of the perinatal skin. And in females, the lesions may be found on the vaginal mucosa and the labia. So in males, the entire scrotum and penis is involved with erosive balanitis. Now balanitis is, it's the inflammation of the foreskin and the head of the penis. So in males, the entire scrotum and penis is involved with balanitis. And in females, the lesions may be found on the vaginal mucosa and the labia. In some infants, the process is generalized with erythematous lesions distant from the diaper area. Now, in some infants, this process is generalized with erythematous lesions distant from the diaper area. In some cases, the generalized process may represent a fungal ID, that is hypersensitivity reaction. So the point to remember is the satellite pustules and the erythematous confluent plaques. And in males, there will be erosive balanitis. And in females, the lesions are found on vaginal mucosa and labia. And in males, the entire scrotum and penis is involved. So this was the clinical manifestation of diaper rash. Now, the differential diagnosis of candidal diaper dermatitis includes other eruptions of the diaper area that may coexist with candidal infection. Now, how we will differentiate candidal diaper dermatitis? And that would include, the differential diagnosis would include eruptions of the diaper area that are coexisting with the candidal infection. Then, for this reason, it is important to establish a diagnosis by means of KOH preparation or culture. Now, the KOH, it's a test. The KOH test, it is the test for Candida albicans. It is also called as the potassium hydroxide preparation. And it is a most important test for fungal test. Basically, it's a fungal test to differentiate dermatophytes and Candida albicans symptoms from the other skin disorders like eczema, psoriasis, or any other skin disorder. So basically, it's a potassium hydroxide test or Candida albicans test. It's basically a test for Candida albicans, and it's a fungal test to differentiate karta hai symptoms of Candida albicans from other skin diseases like psoriasis and eczema. Now, preventive measures. So, what we will advise to the parents, that use diapers which are made of single layer porous soft cloth. Single layer soft cloth, porous soft cloth. Change nappies as soon as they are soiled. Don't over tighten the diapers. Don't scrub the baby's bottom. And avoid plastic or synthetic diapers. So these are some of the preventive measures that parents should take, or the physician should counsel and advise to the parents, that use diapers of single layer porous soft cloth. Don't use over tightened clothing or over tightened diapers. Avoid plastic diapers, synthetic diapers, use cotton diapers. Don't scrub baby's bottom, and frequently change the diapers or the nappies as soon as they are soiled. So basically, till now we have discussed definition of diaper rash, etiology, clinical manifestations, then preventive measures. Now, when the baby comes to the clinic, or when the mother complains that the baby has diaper rash, so initially what she would complain would be, she would complain that there is redness of the skin in the nappy area, severe itching or erythematous patches are present. And when the physician will check or the mother will check, the skin will be slightly warmed to touch. Then we will advise these preventive measures. Then general management. Diaper dermatitis is prevented by keeping the area clean and dry and avoiding the use of disposable absorbent diapers. Means keep that area clean and dry and don't use disposable diapers. The washed cotton diapers should be rinsed in dilute lemon juice. cotton diapers should be used and they should be rinsed in dilute lemon juice. Then emollients and mild topical steroids with antifungal agents are useful in the acute phase. In acute phase, topical steroids and emollients are very useful because they have antifungal agents. Treatment consists of application of imidazole cream at least 2 times daily. Then corticosteroid should not be continued for more than few days. Protection of the diaper area by application of thick zinc oxide paste overlying the anti-candidal preparation. It is also very helpful. The paste is more easily removed with mineral oil than with soap and water. The paste that we are applying that can be removed with mineral oil rather than soap and water. Then fungal ID reactions that we had discussed, hypersensitivity skin. So fungal ID reactions, they gradually abate with successful treatment of diaper dermatitis or may be treated with mild corticosteroid preparation. But we don't have to use corticosteroids for more than few days. When reoccurrences of diaper candidus are frequent, it is very helpful to prescribe a course of oral anti-candidal therapy to decrease the yeast population in GIT. When it's reoccurring, then it is very helpful to prescribe oral candidal therapy that would decrease the population of the yeast in the GIT. Then homeopathic management. So here are some of the common homeopathic medicines which are used for diaper rash and their symptomatic indications. So first is Belladonna. Now Belladonna, general indications of Belladonna are the skin is very dry, red, and it's warmth to touch. Then mentally the child is very entertaining and jovial, happy when well, but gets violent when he is sick. Then mood is changeable. The child cries out suddenly and after a while stops crying as if nothing has happened. This was a general indication of Belladonna. Then particular symptoms when we have to prescribe it in diaper rash, that would be skin lesions. They are uniform. The skin lesions are in uniform strategy. So skin lesions are uniform, smooth, shining, and they are bright red in color. The skin lesions would be smooth, shiny, and bright red in color. The skin is hot or warm to touch. And the rashes, the skin rashes, they are very sensitive. The skin is very sensitive and the child cries when touched. Next is borax. General indications of borax are the child screams while nursing, gets startled easily, fear of downward motion. Then particular symptoms of borax, skin rashes in the perianal area, in lower abdominal area and in the groin region. And the rashes are like urticaria. So urticaria like rashes are present in borax. And erythematous rashes are present. There is swelling of the skin and severe itching is present in borax. Then graphitis. The child is very chilly. This is a general indication of graphitis. Chilly patient takes cold easily, fatty, pale, and there's tendency to skin infections and tendency to skin affections or infections and constipation. Then particular symptoms are eruptions are moist, especially in the groin region. Then eruptions, there is discharge. From the eruptions, there is discharge, oozing, discharging a watery fluid, glutinous, sticky fluid, thin and sticky. Means from the eruptions, there is discharge of glutinous, thin, sticky discharge. Eruptions are very painful. And eruptions are moist, moist eruptions, and they're very painful. And the pain gets worse from heat. Then mesenium, general indication, patient is chilly, very sensitive to cold air, and again, he is prone to skin affections. Then particular symptoms would be eczema, with shiny, fiery red areola. And the vesicles are very small in size with terrible itching. Severe, terrible itching is present in mesarium. The itching is intolerable. Intolerable, terrible, worse itching. And it gets worse from warmth. Warmth or at bedtime when going to sleep at night time. So eczema, vesicles are small in size with terrible itching, severe itching, intolerable itching. And that itching gets worse from warmth at bedtime and at night during sleep. And from the eruptions, the secretions, it produces scab. Scab forms, or scab mein se pus formation hota hai, pus oozes out. Then arsenicum album, general indication, patient is very chilly, pale. Then burning pains, which gets better by heat, very restless, anxious. This was the general indication of arsenicum album. Then particular symptoms, skin gets blackish, blackish coloration of the skin after scratching. Itching is present. Then after scratching, the skin becomes black in color. Severe itching and burning sensation, and patient gets relief after warmth, after application of warmth. So skin gets blackish after scratching, and itching and burning sensation, which is relieved by warmth. And skin is very thick, scaly skin. Then last medicine is Rustoxycodendron. Chilly patient, yes, sulfur is also there. Rustox, general indication. Chilly patient is very much chilly, restless, anxious, and better, feels better by continued motion. Then particular symptoms of Rustoxycodendron are skin of the diaper area is covered with numerous vesicles with itching, and the parts involved, they are swollen, and the rashes, they get worse at night and feels better by warmth application and in the dry weather. Then sulfur, general indications, patient is thermally hot, then great desire for sweets, and patient does not like bathing, does not want to be washed. Then particular indications of sulfur, when to prescribe in diaper rash, skin is dry, scaly eruptions with easy suppuration. Then severe itching, severe burning is present, patient likes to scratch. Severe itching is present and feels better by scratching, but after some time it makes the itching worse. Excoriation of the skin is there, especially in the folds, and the itching gets worse after scratching and washing, and in the evening also. So these were the homeopathic management of diaper rash. With this, we complete with our topic, diaper rash. Thank you.